good evening from the Lakeside. Everything has fallen silent after another day of memories here, which saw the men and the women get underway in the quarterfinals. But before we get to that, our afternoon session, which was live in BBC Two, tied up the second round in the men's. And first up, it was Belgium against Holland. And it was this man, Jan Dekker, who was consistent at best, an 85 average, but he took enough doubles out to see off Geert De Vos and go through to the quarterfinals. Jan Dekker would be taking on the winner of our other second round game this afternoon. You know that guy's face, three-time champion Martin Adams, finding form again, and he just did enough against Ross Montgomery, who had real problems with his doubles. So it was England who beat Scotland. It'll be Dekker, Adams in a quarterfinal. And the other quarterfinal in the bottom half of the men's draw, which you can see tomorrow evening from 5:30 on the red button, is Huddersfield's James Wilson, the highest ranked player in this part of the draw, against a very informed Alan Norris. And the top half of the draw then, it's our focal point tonight at the Lakeside. You're going to see highlights from both these games. A little bit later, the man who threw a 100 average in the second round, Stephen Bunting, against the Dutchman who didn't even get to complete his last 16 encounter after an injury to Martin Atkins. But first it's Tony Eccles, who has already disposed of Daryl Fitton and Wesley Harms in what he says will be his last Lakeside. And he faced big Robbie Green, the machine from Merseyside, who has been bullish and in patches brilliant so far this week. And Green had the best of the opening session, 3-1 up at the break. And we join it in the fifth with Kong 2-1 up in legs.
Game on. Well, you can never really tell, can you? But that double 16 did feel big.
140.
It felt like it could have been a turning point. Robbie was so far ahead in
99.
That leg. Had a bit of bad luck with a bounce out. Bit of carelessness, missing the big 20 to give himself a chance at tops. And then all of a sudden, Tony was looking at double 16 to nick 56. The leg against the darts. If he had... My goodness me. But he didn't.
97.
Well, those are those legs of darts that you always feel are crucial, where both players have darts at doubles. And it hasn't happened very often in this match. We've had 21 legs of darts up to this point. And there have only been four where both players have had shots at doubles. That was one of them. Tony missing a crucial dart. What could prove to be a crucial dart at double 16. Robbie fills him up again. Number 9 of the match for him.
Well, the 165 was perfect. That dart is perfect. That one was almost perfect, but just a bit too high.
100. Robbie in a quiet 125.
Robbie followed the 165 with a perfect 180. And he'll stay there now. Bullseye he needs. What a way to do it!
Shot on the first set, Robbie Green!
What a finish from Robbie Green! Is there any coming back from that? Tony Eccles, though, shows that he's made of steel.
Well, the most remarkable thing about Tony Eccles' 122 against Wesley Harms was the context of that checkout. And that's another big one for Robbie Green. 125 checkout in brilliant fashion. And it won in the set. Bull, 25, bull. Never a man that betrays his emotions, but even he had a self-satisfied knot about the way that he finished that off. And still the scoring is so impressive. He's into double figures for Maxima in this game himself. Tony can't quite find his fifth.
My goodness me.
Ruth can't cope. And he's 4-1 up.
98. Tony in a choir, 121.
Treble 17 and bull.
97.
Well, surely not.
Robbie in a choir, 164.
Surely not. Treble 18. Leaves the bullseye for a 164.
Yes, game shot on the first leg. Robbie Green.
This is darts from a different planet.
Second leg is Robbie to throw first. Game on.
Set the Sky Plus. Just wind it back in 10 minutes' time to make sure we've seen this right. 130, 125, 164 in the space of five legs from Robbie Green. He's never reached the semi-final, but this performance is certainly worthy of a place at the top table in the last four of the World Championships. It has been magnificent. 67% finishing, average score of nearly 96, and four ton-plus checkouts in five and a bit sets. Magnificent.
And how big does that missed 45. Double 16 from Tony Eccles feel now? It was to move 2-1 ahead in the fifth set.
140.
Since then, Kong's calmly taken out 125 with bull 25 bull and 164. The second highest checkout of the week. He owns the highest.
Robbie, you require 121.
Treble 17. Bullseye.
96.
So close. You just expected him to hit. That would have been a third successive leg where he'd won it with a ball.
Robbie, you require 25.
As it is, a mere 25. Double four.
21. Tony, you require 116.
Felt a little bit rushed. Just a tiny bit. Can Tony take advantage? Treble 20 for double 18.
40. Robbie, you require four.
Double two. Double one. We haven't seen this. The finishing line is getting closer.
No
and
score.
The doubles are getting smaller.
Tony, you require 76.
Double eight then for Eccles. Leg against the darts.
Yes, that's been shot. And the second leg.
Gets it.
Tony Eccles. Third leg, it's Tony to throw first. Game on.
Robbie Green had missed six darts at doubles in that leg. He'd only missed seven darts at doubles in the first five sets.
24.
Robbie had match darts in the Windmouth
final
and the Zagadan final and lost both matches. Runner-up in the Masters in 2009. Martin Adams beating 7-6, but this is just fantastic from both players. Trading blows, trading huge scores, trading massive outs. This is five darts in a row, and that is six. And Robbie Green has the chance of darting immortality when he returns to the hockey. 141 points away from a perfect nine-dart leg. Some people can't watch.
59.
It felt like he was going to do it.
The place was bouncing. Absolutely bouncing, willing him on. £52,000 it would have been worth.
82.
17 for double top.
62.
He doesn't want to lose this leg, having missed darts at a double to take a 2-0 lead in this set.
142.
And there is some pressure from Tony Eccles. He is such a fighter. Double 10 to break back.
No score.
He's missed more darts at a double.
Tony, you require 57.
There's the 17. Surely he won't miss. Double 10.
37.
Robbie has another chance.
Robbie, you require 20.
It's all right, Ruth. It's just a game of darts.
He's missed his last 11 darts at doubles now, Robbie Green. Double 10. A leg against the darts to move a leg away. Double five. One more shot at double five. And he's missed again. And now Tony Eccles looks at double ten. Double five for Tony, two.
No score.
He busts. One for double two for Robbie Green.
14 missed
Robbie
darts.
Robbie require five.
To move a leg away from the semi-finals. He was playing so well. But this is what pressure does. Double two. Oh, finally,
Robbie Green,
having finished so well throughout the match, he starts to wobble.
Robbie to throw first. Game on.
Will that be his only wobble?
And now he's in a position where he's got the darts in his hand for the match.
99.
That final in the Masters in 2009, he missed a match dart in that for a 7-3 win against Martin Adams, and he lost.
125.
Tony Eccles showed his resilience against Harms. He needs even more resilience now. He's got to win the next two legs to stay alive.
58.
Remember, he has said he's going to retire after this tournament. This could be the last leg of his professional career. Lynn couldn't bear to watch it.
41.
I wonder what's in that phone. Please let it end. It is always harder when you can't do anything about it.
82.
Please let him have a 1-2-2 checkout. That's what she'll have texted.
140.
But it isn't over yet. 67 points. In fact, Tony effectively has got the darts back just about. Treble with the last dart, absolutely crucial.
Twice in a row he hit the treble 19 last time. He's on no finish. 162 is one of those bogey numbers. And Tony Eccles, the Viper, is coiled and ready to pounce.
56.
On 62.
Tony require 62.
To break again. Double 16.
30.
No.
Robbie, you require 106.
For the match. Great first start. 14. It's double 16 for a 5-1 win.
90. Tony, you require 32.
Another match start. Goes begging. Double 16 for Tony Eccles. Double 8 now to stay alive. He's got to hit it.
Yeah,
he has hit it. And he takes this
Tony
set
Eccles
into a deciding fifth leg. He's the man that never knows when he's beaten.
Game on.
Well, Wesley Harms was on 40, but didn't get a dart at it in the previous round because Tony took out a big one.
60.
Robbie did get a match dart here, but he missed it. And that is a huge 106 checkout.
100.
Where's Robbie scoring? Oh, there it is.
95.
Well, he came back from 2-1 and more significantly 3-2 down to beat Wesley Harms 4-3. Surely he can't come back from 4-1 down to take out the number 4 seed as well. He's giving himself an outstanding chance of taking this set. One step at
94.
A time for Tony Eccles. It's the only
Tony
way he can go.
81.
But 81 here. 16. He's missed it. Needed the 16 for double top.
49.
Funny how being on the brink of defeat frees up the arm. And being on the brink of victory makes it 30. Almost impossible to release the dart.
32.
No pressure, or not much, but this is for a set.
Yes. Yes, game shot on the sixth set. Tony Eccles.
So a series of big out shots from Green, but he just couldn't get the job done, and they split the first two legs of the seventh set, and that's where we rejoin the action.
Three legs left, potentially, in this set. Tony Eccles has to break the green throw. He has managed it on five occasions. Robbie Green holds 44. Two-thirds of his throws. Eccles must hold and has to break green once.
100.
That takes it to 4-3. Eccles then needs to hold again all the way through. That takes us to a deciding and thrilling ninth set. All ifs, buts and maybes, of course.
59.
But it's only going to take one moment of inspiration from Eccles. And you never know, this game could completely change.
97.
Doesn't look as though that inspiration is likely to come in this leg. He will only have one more chance.
Robbie's hit 164 already in this match.
41. Robbie, you'd acquire 164.
This time he doesn't really need it, and this time he definitely can't get it, starting with a one, but straight back in the treble 20. That red bit's seen some traffic this
81.
Match. But not in this leg from Tony.
96. Robbie, you'd acquire 83.
Tony nowhere. Robbie to move a leg away. He's on 41. Having hit the treble there.
51.
So 32. And a double 16, the one he missed.
Tony just assessing what he needs, and he's going to go for it.
100.
Gets it as well. But double 16 for Robbie Green to again move within a leg of the place in the semi-finals. Double 8, double 4. Tension 24. Rising. The heat is on.
Tony in the choir, 81.
Here's the chance for Eccles to break. Needs to break. 12 for Bull. Double 13 instead. Massive darts.
55.
Miss.
At one stage, Robbie Green missed 14 darts in a row to move to within a leg. Then he had one dart.
Eight.
For a place in the semi-finals, which he missed. Under all sorts of pressure. One more dart at double four.
Tony Uruguaya, 26.
So does he go for the double 13? Now five for double four. Double four for the break that he needs.
22.
Well, he's had his chances.
Robbie Uruguaya, eight.
Double two. Yes.
Yes, game shot. On the third leg. Robbie Green, fourth leg. It's Tony throwing first. Game on.
At the ninth attempt.
29.
His finishing early in the game was sensational. But just when it looked as though Kong could do no wrong, he has frozen as the finishing line approaches.
96.
He's hit only three of his last 20 doubles, including a missed match dart.
We say he missed one match dart. He only got the chance to miss one. I wonder how many more would or could have been missed in that deciding leg of the sixth set.
100.
He has been able to manoeuvre his way to within one leg of the match. Eccles, at his best when he's under pressure, has had two ton 40s.
Tried to G himself up, did Robbie, before this visit to the Oki.
125.
And apart from a loose first dart, it worked. But he's not on a finish. And Tony will be.
63.
What'd he do for a 140 here?
80.
Great last dart.
Tony, you'd acquire 129.
Will he be back?
Treble 20 and bull.
He will be back.
42.
And he can do this in two darts.
Robbie, you'd acquire 100.
This is for a place in the semi-finals. For Robbie Green, the fourth seed. There's the treble 20. Tops he needs.
60.
Two more match darts missed. Monumental 87 for Tony Eccles. Double 18. Double 9.
78.
And the finishing line inside again.
40.
G's himself up. It's tops for the match.
He's missed three more of them. The missed match dart count rises to six. And Tony has a chance at double four to level this set. Just one chance at double two.
Five. Robbie, you require 14.
He's missed four darts to stay alive. Robbie has missed six for the match. Double four now. He misses another two. This is absolutely extraordinary. Double two to stay alive for Eccles.
Yes, that's game shots. And the fourth leg, Tony Eccles.
Wow. A leg he had to win. It's Robbie who will throw first. I think Tony thought he'd broken there, he hasn't.
Fifth leg, it's Robbie to throw first. Game on!
Well, 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 Robbie. How are you feeling?
96.
Still scoring okay, that's a solid start. He has the darts in this leg. But those darts, those match darts, will be weighing
95.
Very heavy on his mind.
I
wonder if that match against Martin Adams has gone through his mind. 5 years ago, missed a match dart for a 7-3 win in the Masters, lost the
99.
Game. The tension palpable, the heat rising all the time, it's hot in the arena, on the stage, it's tropical. But a 140, again, takes him that little bit closer. But he will be thinking, as his scoring still holds up, that it's all going to be about his bottle on the double. And that's big pressure from Tony Eccles. He'll come down here, brilliant, 171.
Tony Eccles, 127.
This is just fantastic from both players. But here comes the finishing line, guys. And it's Robbie.
42.
Who's there first again.
Robbie Unicorn, he's missed. 36.
Darts for the match. Game. But this time, he finds the double.
Robbie Green.
That is sheer relief on the face of Robbie Green. He threw some stunning stuff all match. He limped over the line. But the Kong, who would be king, is two games away from a coronation. Credit Tony Eccles. He played his part in a superb match. If it is to be his last on the Lakeside stage, well, what a match. But Robbie Green is through to the semi-finals.
Robbie, congratulations. You're through to your first Lakeside semi-final, but some heart-stopping moments towards the end.
Yeah, I made it difficult for myself, but to be fair, Tony played well on the comeback, and I think I got caught up watching what he was doing instead of concentrating on what I was doing, and it got harder to hit that double. That double seemed to close in. Very small.
How difficult is it to keep your composure when you've played so well in patches during the match and then you just can't hit the critical finish for love nor money?
It's really annoying. And I think that's where the mindset comes in, into darts, where you've got to keep believing that you're going to hit it. And when I left the 36, I knew I was going to nail it. Like, my daughter's birthday is on the 18th. And whenever I say to her, give me a double, she always shouts double 18. And in one of the other matches, as soon as I hit the double 18, I pointed straight at her. So that's for you. Well, that one's for her as well.
Well, it was obviously meant to be. And you've made such great progress every year you've come to the Lakeside. What does it mean to you to now be down to the last four?
Everything. It's something we play all year for, and you can't really put it into words. There's such great players that have stood on that stage playing that, and now to get amongst them, and it's nice to be in the semis now, but I have to look further than that and say, well, I've got to win the semi-final, otherwise it counts for nothing.
Well, two matches to go. Very well done tonight.
One match to go. I've got to win my next game. And that's going to be a tough one, no matter who. I've got a feeling who it'll be, but it's going to be a good Liverpool ding-dong.
Well done tonight.
Cheers.
Don't get ahead of yourself yet, Robbie. He's in uncharted territory, and the same could be said for the man he's just referenced, top seed Stephen Bunting, whose best performance at Lakeside to date was the 2011 quarter-final. He was a massive favourite, though, to go through against the Netherlands' Rick Hofstra, but they split the first session, taking two sets each. Then Bunting found a little form in the fifth to go 3-2 up, and it's one leg all in the sixth, and that's where we drop in on the action.
This
year, Rick Hofstra, runner-up at the Tops of Ghent, losing to Ross Montgomery. Beaten by Robbie Green in the last 32 at the World Masters. And you've got to go back to January for a German Gold Cup victory. Just being put under pressure now.
Trading maximums. Bunting with his eighth, Hofstra with his sixth, the tournament with its 200th. And if you do come all the way from New Zealand and lose your first round match, having won your preliminary, it's pretty good in the crowd.
Only dart number six that stopped perfection there.
There is Mike Day, all the way from Auckland. He's had fun.
43, Mercury by 136.
Jan Dekker enjoying the fact that the tension is on other people.
96. Stephen Uruguay, 155.
He'll fancy his chances here, Rick Hofstra, not least because Stephen hasn't hit anything over 84. all tournament.
84. Ricky Urquhart, 40.
Tops to hold his throw. Did miss a couple in the last leg. They dent the confidence. There's another one gone. And another one. Needs this.
Yeah, this game's short. And a third leg.
And gets it.
Rick Armstrong. Forward leg, it's Stephen to throw first. Game on.
There you go, Wilma, he says. That's what I can do.
96.
Stephen, that's what I can do.
9-6, he leads in terms of 180s in this game.
99.
97 and 180 in this leg for Bunting. Cursory glance at the scoreboard.
60.
On a finish.
73. Stephen, you require 164.
20 then for Stephen. Again, in a position just to set things up for himself.
88.
76 left. He's looking for all the world at the moment, as though we're going to go to another crucial, decisive leg in set number six.
Stephen Urquhart is 76.
Which the pressure will really be on Rick Hofstra. But first of all, Bunting's got to finish this. 16 for double top.
56.
Sped up, really sped up. Oh, bullseye. Now up for the treble 20.
48. Stephen, you require 20.
Double 10 then for Stephen Bunting.
Yeah, this game shot and the fault line. Stephen Bunting.
He's missed 40 doubles.
Black, it's Rick to throw first. Game on.
Almost half of them set darts. But if Stephen Bunting can break here, he'll fancy his chances of romping away.
140.
But it's a big if, because Hofstra under pressure started with a ton 40.
Still struggling at top, Stephen Bunting has only hit it twice in 14 attempts in this match so far. Not a single set really where Stephen's finishing has been exceptional. 2-140s though for Rick Hofstra at the beginning of a leg that for him is crucial. Wins it, it's 3-3. Loses it, he's 4-2 down. Only the one leg separating the two men at the moment.
Ton 40 and ton 40 is mighty impressive. When you're throwing at two legs all for three sets
96.
All. That's pretty good too. A finish of 1-2-5. Can Bunting claw himself to a finish?
138.
You betcha.
125.
It's a pressure on 125. Rick Hofstra. Just adjusts. Needed the treble for a finish.
61.
He has 64 left. 164. It'll be Stephen's first big check out of the tournament. It's not going to happen. So Hofstra again in with a chance. 64 for the set to tie it up at three apiece.
64.
Two legs all. 64 points all. Hofstra with a first crack at it. 16 and double 16.
32.
He missed big 16. That was really wild.
Stephen, you require 64.
Not only did he missed it the wrong side of the double. What can Stephen do?
This is for 4-2. Double 8.
Yeah, yes! The same shot and the set side. Stephen Mulder.
Surely now the bullet has fired his way into the semi-finals.
Seventh set, first lock. It's Stephen to throw first. Game on.
Well, the bullet is hot. And for the man from Frisian, it looks as though things are now pretty black and white. Three sets
97.
Left. He's got to win them all. 2-0 up he was. 4-2 down now. That makes it sound as though he's just imploded. Hasn't been the way of it at all. It has been nip and tuck all the way through. Sets 4, 5 and 6 have all gone to deciding legs, critically. Bunting has won them all. And going through Rick's mind now, what happened when he was on 64? Single 16, no problem, 48 left. Did he just change his mind mid-throw? It was really bizarre. Looking for big 16, puts it the wrong side of the double. Still 48 left, only with one dart. Although he set up the finish, he never got an opportunity to try and take it out. And it's the kind of error that is so critical against a player of any calibre, let alone Stephen Bunting.
I wonder if he aimed at single 8, changed his mind literally mid-throw, aimed down a bit towards the big 16, just assuming he'd hit it, because for these guys hitting big 16 is 99 times out of 100, if not 99 and a half, and just overcompensated under pressure, decided instead of going 8 tops, 16,
97.
Double 16. Either way, a big moment in this match. And Stephen now already on a finish of 74.
One on row. Stephen, you require 74.
The first leg of set number 7. It will take him within 2 legs of a place in the semi-finals. 20 for double top.
Yeah,
bang, bang, bang!
The first line.
He is firing now on all cylinders.
Second line is Rick the Crow first.
Not a vintage performance from Stephen Bunting, but the finishing line is approaching. It's only the third time he's hit double top all match.
96.
He arrived at the Lakeside saying things are looking bubbly for the bullet, having practiced his doubles, but back to the practice board. 16 out of 56, 29%. That's simply not good enough. That is not championship winning form. And if he had a bit of an aura about him ahead of this quarterfinal, he's lost it. Even if he does go on to win 5-2.
Well, it's easy to build up an aura when you do what he did in Hull, when he retained his World Masters title without dropping a single set all
85.
The way through.
Not that easy.
Well, what I'm saying is it's easy to build up that kind of aura. If you can do that, then today you're 2 down against Hofstra in the quarterfinals. Looking ominous now for Rick Hofstra, part of a big Dutch contingent, a Dutch contingent that will be swelled over the forthcoming months by the arrival back on the BDO tour of Co Stomper.
60.
Just going back to Stephen's aura.
43. Or is 160.
Take a while to create, and very quick to dissipate. Just ask Manchester United.
Oh, Monte. Stephen, you require 150.
A little nod of self-appreciation. 158 here for Bunting. No, the treble. Double 19, 158.
Yeah, that came short. And the second one.
Biggest finish of the tournament by a street for Stephen Bunting. And it moves in within a leg of his first ever World Championship third semi-final. Magnificent 158 against the Hofstra throw. He's nearly there.
The finishing line very much in focus for Stephen Bunting.
98.
Has Rick Hofstra got any fight left in him, having seen Stephen take out 158 to move a leg away? That would break the hearts of
39
lesser men.
Seven bounce outs in this game for Stephen Bunting.
However, with six darts, he's got 1 point fewer than Rick has with three. Back he comes.
125.
Well, Wesley Harms is one for watching the DVDs and analysing every leg, every set, where things went wrong. It's pretty clear for Rick. Only one leg of darts, really, he needs to watch. The last one of set number four. Missed set darts.
81.
A double 16, double 8, lost the leg. Well, instead of being 3-1 up at the break, it was 2-2. And from that point, it very, very rapidly went south.
Yeah,
he's coming now. He's on his way. Isn't it extraordinary? A match can turn on two missed darts. Stephen Bunting has missed 19 set darts. Rick Hofstra has missed just two. This is for the match.
Missed the big 14 there. Well, well, well. Would have left him ball.
44.
Tops if he comes
97.
Back. Got to take 97 out. No two ways about it. This is massive. Treble 18. Some way away, truth be told.
57.
This is it then for Stephen Bunting.
Stephen, you require 14.
Man, long seen as a world champion elect, has never got past the quarterfinals until now. Tops for the bullet. 2-0 down. He wins 5-2. Hofstra looks stunned. Bunting elated. Stephen Bunting makes his first world championship semi-final. A thrilling victory that was closer than the 5-2 scoreline suggests. And the bullet marches on.
Well, Stephen, congratulations, your first Lakeside semi-final. But were you at all concerned in the early stages of that match?
Definitely. I mean, Rick comes straight out of the blocks. He's a fantastic player. I knew he was going to do that. My two other games, I lost the darts and won the first set against the other two. So when I lost the first set, I was under a bit of pressure, but I managed to get through.
Well, it was great composure that you didn't start to panic in that situation, especially with the prize of your first Lakeside semi-final hovering.
No, there was definitely a tiny bit of panic in there, trust me. I was really nervous tonight, I don't know why, but I've been on the practice board all day, and obviously I've been on in the afternoon and tonight and the night, so a tiny bit of preparation difference, but I got the win, so that's all that matters.
And let's look forward to that semi-final. Robbie Green, did you manage to catch any of his quarter-final?
Of course I did, yeah. I mean, Robbie's a really good friend of mine, and we're both from Merseyside, so it's going to be a bit of extra spice in the semi-final. There's going to be a scouser in the final, so it's going to be really good for either one of us.
Well, we cannot wait for that one. It's going to be a real ding-dong. You've earned it, enjoy it, and congratulations tonight.
Thank you.
An old Scouse affair then in one of her men's semi-finals on Saturday, Bunting Green. But earlier today, we saw some amazing darts in the ladies' draw. Eileen de Graaf actually won her first set with an average north of 91. But back came last year's finalist, Lisa Ashton, to win it in that sudden death leg. A real thriller appreciated by the Lakeside crowd. So let's have a look at the ladies' draw and just draw breath. Fallon Sherrick, the 19-year-old English girl, against the defending champion, Anastasia Dobromyslova. I don't want to miss out on the red button tomorrow evening. We'll also see the conqueror of Trina Gulliver, the 9-times champion, Tamara Schur, who goes up against that woman there, Lisa Ashton. The other half of the ladies' draw we took care of tonight, Arena Armstrong, whose checkout percentages have been great so far, and Dita Hedman, who's been averaging over 80. And it's Julie Gore, who's finally won at the Lakeside in the quarterfinal against Denmark's Anne-Louise Peters. And here's what happened. It was the Danish girl who brought the bacon home. Anne-Louise Peters, a fairly easy day in the office, actually, against Julie Gore from Wales. And Dita Hedman, the number one seed, but too often the bridesmaid here at the Lakeside, is living up to her billing. A 2-0 win over Arena Armstrong, so it's England-Denmark in that last four clash. So an interesting evening, to say the least. We're left with six in the men's draw and six in the ladies' draw, and tomorrow we will get that down to four, because we get two more ladies' quarterfinals and two more men's. That's going to be in the red button from 5:30 tomorrow evening. We're going to see James Wilson, the number two seed, taking on Alan Norris. I think that's the closest of all quarterfinal draws. And then, as we know from the second round action today, we're going to see Martin Adams against the Netherlands' Jan Dekker, back in a quarterfinal. But will the experience show through for the Wolf? Well, up next, we get Darts Extra, and tomorrow afternoon on BBC Two, it's just me and my old mucker, Bobby. We're looking back at the tournament so far. Good night.